Dear students, today we will discuss the implementation of atomicity and durability. So the transaction management and recovery management component of a database help to implement the atomicity and durability. The shadow copy scheme is an example for this. Now, what is the shadow copy scheme? In shadow copy scheme, it assumes that only one transaction is active at a time. We also assume that database is simply a file on disk and a pointer called DB pointer, which point to the current copy of the database. Now, in this shadow copy scheme, a transaction then that want to update the database first create a copy of the database, and all the updates are done on the new database copy. Now, at any point, two possibilities are there. The first possibility is that the transaction will be aborted, and the second possibility is that transaction will complete. Now, first we will discuss the first possibility, that if the transaction will be aborted. So, if at any point the transaction has to be aborted, then the system delete the new copy and old copy is used. As we can see in this diagram, that before update, the DB pointer points toward the old copy of the database. And after aborted, the DB pointer point towards the old copy of the database and the new copy of the database to be deleted. Now, if the transaction complete, it is committed as follows, that the operating system write all the pages of the new database copy to the disk. The DB pointer is made to point to the new copy of the database, and the new copy then become the current copy of the database. So like we can see in this example, that before update, the DB pointer points toward the old copy of the database, and after update, the DB pointer point toward the new copy of the database and the old copy of the database to be deleted. In this way, we implement the atomicity and durability of a transaction. Thank you so much.